Hi folks. Welcome. Welcome, welcome, welcome. What have we got planned for tonight? We are taking a look at let's get the map working. That's right, we've got a pop-up text, so we don't have to worry too much. Let's get that working. Okay, right, so we are looking at Return to Maerdy. So this is new coming soon from Mesh Tools. I thought there was going to be an advanced preview of it on the Dovetail channel, but there isn't really an opportunity to do that at the moment. So everyone thought it'd be good to just get it shown. Let's have a look at it and get it out there. It's really interesting actually. So I'll talk about what's in the pack and why it's different to the Maerdy branch route, which is done by the same people. Right, so this is a tutorial scenario, and I am not going to read all of the pop-ups because some of these pop-ups have got all the text in the world in them. So we are. Let me just close this one, and it's going to pop another one up. Right, so we're here to learn the basics of the battery loco. So let's open the cab windows and doors. We can do that. Door. Can we do that while that's up? No, we can't. Right. Two very important instruments over on the right. Okay, so we've got this one here on the top, which is the voltmeter, and then this is the ammeter. So what we're driving at the moment is a Type 3B, which is a battery electric loco. Right. So, as I said, there's lots and lots of text on here, and this really gives a really good tutorial to teach you how to drive this thing because the simulation is really, really accurate. There's a lot of stuff in there. So, as you said, the battery will give you about 3 hours of use. And then you've got the. Really gives a really good tutorial to teach you how to drive this thing because the simulation is really, really accurate. There's a lot of stuff in there. So, as you said, the battery will give you about 3 hours of use. And then you've got the ammeter. The current circuit is currently broken, so up here we need to just make the circuit so we get power. And then you can see that the voltmeter has risen up. Right, now the braking system. So there's two types of brake. There is. Let me up to that way. Right, so there is this handle over here, which is the handbrake. And then you've got throttle levers down here. So this actually works as a like a combined. Power and dynamic brake. Now I'm running the advanced version of this loco, so but to be honest, it's familiar to drive, but there's an awful lot of detail and so forth in there. One thing to be aware of is that the handbrakes will actually fade; they'll heat up and get brake fade. Christian 2920, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. So if you find yourself using the handbrake an awful lot, you're going to find yourself actually being able to stop less and less well, and it says you get sparks, which is interesting. I haven't seen that yet. All right, so we've got the rear static brake, which is the electric brake, and this just talks about the use of the electric brake, which has the standard thing: the faster you're going, the more effective it is, and it is quite effective even at about 10 miles an hour. So we've got light control, so you can press control 1 to 4, although there's no middle lamp, so you've only got 1, 3 and 4. And then similarly, you've got 5 to 8, which do the rear lamps. And then if you do control shift, it puts a red filter on them, so you can have red lamps in any one of those places as well. And then you've got switches here, which actually turn the lamps on and off. Once we get through this and we can start driving, then I will play with some of this stuff so we can have a look. Benny Boy Blues, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. So if we come out the front here, and we, oh no, there's also a cab switch for the light, for the cab light, so we can test the cab light on. Scott, New York, NY845, thanks for the follow. Apologies if I miss anyone with the follows. I'll put the map on once we get going. Right, in order to aid with the adhesion, you've got two sets of sanders. You've got forward and rear sanders, which are both down here. Using the X and C keys, actually. Right, the engine's fitted with a second circuit breaker. So that is this one up here, and this is the electronic, or the electrical supply, for things like the klaxon and the lights and so forth. But that's on. The engine's got two warning devices, one of which is a foot-operated gong, which will blow in a minute, and then you've got the klaxon. So that's the gong, and then you've got the klaxon on the roof. Right, let's get moving. First, we need to engage the reverser. Now, the handle is actually already in, so you don't have to press the E key. I'll show you that as well. Then we've got the W and S key. So if I press the E key... These pop-ups. Now, this is really interesting. You really want to read this when you get to this. I'm not going to read it out. This basically tells you about how the power serial, parallel, and so forth works, or why it works. There's an awful lot of detail in here, and it will also tell you about interlocks and so forth, stop you moving the controls in certain incompatible situations. Right, it's time to get moving. Let's head on up to the colliery. So we do need to set our route. There you go, look, so this is where you can take it. So pressing the E key off, so you can click that in, then we can push that forward. Right, so let's get some lights on. So let's just get, let's put those on. I don't think that's probably quite correct. That's express passenger. We're probably not an express passenger. Let's put number 4 on, that'll do. And then, like I said, if you press the shift variation of it, control shift 4, you get a red lens on the front that you can take on and off. Right. Now, J.I. Brewer, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. So we're going to take the handbrake off, and we're going to put it into notch 1. Let's get this door open. Crazy Kylie, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. So you can... raise and lower the door, the windows. Let's turn that cab light off, we don't need that. We only need to be doing about 10, but we do need to set that path. I forgot to set the path. Shortly we'll be reaching the steep upward section, we will be in a minute anyway. So we'll take that point across there, and that puts us in the right place. Right, so we're going downhill at the moment. Let's just have a look on the outside. Isn't this lovely? Exquisite detail, it really is. There's not a lot to it, is there, really? It's only basically a powered bogey. So you can see they put the e-brake on and it's rapidly dropped off in speed. Right, now we're going to be going uphill a section. So now the guidance is to keep it to around 10 miles an hour. CJG1121997, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Quite a steep uphill section here. Notice how the headlights actually appeared. I got messed up when I was practicing with this earlier on, and I was sitting there pressing control keys, going, "Why can't I turn the lights on?" And I sent a message to Mesh Tools, "Why can't I turn the lights on your loco? What's broken?" And they said, "Are you moving?" I said, "Yeah." And they said, "It's usually quite unhealthy to put the lights on the outside of the loco while you're moving." Okay, fair enough. Jerino Kovac, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. There's lots of little tiny touches. So one of the things that I found today that I really liked, Sharpie6801, thank you for the follow, is if you ring the bell, you see how you get a bell sound. Yeah, sounds good. If you ring the bell twice in reasonable succession to where you're ringing it while it's ringing, the second one sounds different. Isn't that clever? I like that. That's a really nice touch for the audio. And I'm not using a different key, I'm just pressing the space bar. But because it knows that it's already ringing, it sounds different. It's very clever. So we've got 211 people watching at the moment. That's epic. Welcome, everybody. If you haven't pressed the follow button yet, press the follow button for regular train sim fun. What locos are included? So there are two locos included in this pack. This is one of them, and this is sort of, this is the, you know, really new and original content. This really is a fabulous piece of kit. It really is. This is the Type 3B loco. I think it comes in a variety of liveries. Mesh Tools are actually in the chat, so they might be able to clarify what it is. Duffers, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. And it also comes with the Austerity J94, which has seen a massive upgrade from the run that was in the original Maerdy branch route. Creamy Goodness, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. Right, so we're going up to here, keeping around the 10 as we were instructed. So you can see your voltmeter, and as you drive over the next 3 hours, you see that dropping. We're not going to be here for 3 hours, don't panic. And this is your ammeter. The idea is if you overdo the ammeter, it will short out and it will reset the... It will reset the breaker up here. I missed another follow. Dayhorn G201, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. Right, so we are coming up here now. We're coming up to Maerdy Colliery Siding 1. What we need to do is we've got three rakes of wagons we just need to sort out. And then what we do is, so having sorted these wagons out, we then go and sort out the some other wagons and take them down. Is this an improved Maerdy route with new DLC or just new DLC? It's a very different Maerdy route. This is Maerdy in the 1970s. The second scenario I'm going to do actually runs the entire length of the route. So you'll be able to see, if you're familiar with Maerdy branch, you'll see very, very clearly what's changed. And the route has radically changed. There's an awful lot of stuff been cut down. So this is how the route looks, or looked in the 70s. Right, there's our wagons up here. Come off the power just a bit quick. So yeah, the J94, which I'm going to cover next, has seen some radical changes, and there's some really clever innovations in there as well. But we'll talk about that when we get there. Right, so we're using gravity to slow us down, and we're still on a 1 in 58 gradient, which is why the thing's slowing down so much. I like that electric hum in the background. I don't know if you can hear that properly. Oh, I didn't stop properly. Oh, well, never mind. Right, we need to stop and couple up to these, so let's move them. Now, the point is set to go round to there. So this scenario has got a number of problems, unfortunately. And this is, as always with these advanced previews, you're looking at content which isn't finished yet. And so again, we're interested in seeing your feedback. You're going to see a number of fails as I run this scenario. That was a genuine fail. That one wasn't supposed to go wrong. There are a couple of other things, like right at the end, it fails you for no particularly good reason. But that's something that's being worked on. This is a tutorial scenario, so this basically gives you a bit of exercise so that you can see the... So you can learn how to use this this new loco. So I'm going to show you the route map in a little while. This section's really about the new loco. Here's the handbrake. It's slowed down. Right, so that's coupled up. Brakes on. And then we can start rolling backwards. So we've got these two rakes of wagons. Now we've got to go and get them onto that line there. Van Liero, yes, I'm going to be using the austerity in the next scenario, and we're going to do a full run-up along the entire length of the route as well. So you'll get a really good look at the route once we get to the next scenario. But I wanted to give this lovely little loco a bit of attention, because it's probably one of my favourite locos at the moment, just because it's really different. It's got its character all of its own. You've got good view out the back, if you get the door out of the way. Have a look at those camera views in a minute. There's a few different camera views. So the line actually sinks down quite rapidly at this point, so I'm going to apply handbrake and get the train stopped. Eventually. Right, now we need to just change that point there, and then effectively we bring all these wagons in, couple them out to those, and then drop them off in there. Right, so we've still got power. At one time I was doing this earlier on, and this happened. We're going. Oh no! What happened was the ammeter went up, and the power cut out, and I ended up rolling down. And no matter what I did, nothing would happen. And it's because the circuit breaker had failed on me. Well, not failed. I'd blown it, quite literally. But we are now off. We're going forwards. So we're moving in the right direction. The detail is incredible, isn't it? It's not a fast unit, it has to be said. You don't really want to go much more than about 10. Wagons to pick up just in front of us. First one is just here. Ooh, crunch. Oh dear, I was busy looking at Skype, that's what I'm blaming that on. Right, so bringing the train, we've got to couple to that wagon next. And then we can run on a flat level at the moment, so it's a bit easier to push these ones. Push them just over to here, and then we'll get on and do the downhill. So at the top end of the route, let me just show you the route map so you can see where we are. This is the top end of the route at the mine, and just here is where Maerdy station used to be, just in there. We've got the sidings, and the route runs down. You'll notice it's all single track now until you get to Porth down here, which isn't too different. But we'll have another look at the map as we do a bit more. The handbrakes are apparently animated on the wagons. So we'll look at that once we get stopped. We're almost there. That's it. And apparently I'm being told by Mesh Tools that I'm not allowed to cheat and apply them above 4 miles per hour, they won't work. Well, that's destroyed all of my gameplay there. Right, so what we need to do now is apply the handbrake on that wagon. Oh yes, there's the handbrake, look. And we'll go and apply the handbrake on that wagon, just so that they don't roll. Right, that's that done. Let's uncouple. Right, now we need to go down and we're going to go and get some wagons from down here. So let us back into reverse, take the handbrake off, and then off we go. So we're on our way down. So I've left the map off because this is a fictional route. It looks a bit silly, I think. It's not a fictional route, sorry, that's not fair. It's a route that doesn't exist anymore. Oh, actually, that map doesn't look bad. Let me turn the map on for you. Ah, you're going to do that. Oh, no, here we go. Right, so coming down the hill. This really is, you know, typical sort of quality to expect from Mesh Tools. It's beautiful models, excellent physics. So we're driving, Drainhorn Man just asked what loco we're driving. We're driving the, it's a Type 3B battery loco. So it's a bit different. You get about 3 hours of drive time before the battery runs out and needs to be recharged. It basically is just a powered bogey, cab on top. Right, we're about to hit the downhill run now. There we go, you can see we just hit the downhill run. We're starting to accelerate. Now again, I can show you the effect of these electric brakes. So if I just, once we get to 10, I'm going to hit brake 1. You'll see how fast that slows down. And it doesn't get you much below about 6. So you can use that one just to maintain your speed. But these brakes are really quite good, as you're going to see in a minute when we bring a heavy train down the hill. This little train is going to have not really have too much trouble keeping control of it. He says, fingers crossed. Let's just say, when I did it before, it was really nice and it worked well. Now we're live on the stream with a ton of people watching. I'm sure it'll go horrendously wrong. 209. Wow. Can you recharge your loco? No. Your scenario is what your loco is. What it is. It starts out fully charged, and that's as far as it goes. Someone's just asked what the other livery variants are. I don't have the list on the top of my head. Let me see if I can get it. Right, we're coming down here. We just got to get past this switch. Point. Brake 2. We're on a 1 in 34 now. Put it on brake 3 just to help slow it down. And then we'll put some handbrake on just to get it stopped. Right, we're at the wrong end of the route here. You need to be going up to that one, if my memory serves. Yes. Right, take it off of the e-brake so we can move it. If you've got the e-brake on, you can't move the reverser. It's one of the interlocks. Right, so we'll put series 1 on and we'll release the handbrake so that we can get going. Move up to series 2. What happens when the battery is flat? The loco will stop. Or if you're on a hill, unless you put the handbrake on, it'll roll back down. So this is the Central Electricity Generating Board, is that CEGB? Right, here we go. Right, so I've just had a list of the liveries. CEGB Bolton Green, CEGB Red, CEGB Bolton Yellow, CEGB Spondon, CEGB Blue, NCB, BR Black, and BR Green. That's all the liveries that are included in the pack. I like this wooden door. That's really nicely done, sort of. Almost looks like a shed on wheels. This is the original shed. Going a bit slow here. I'm spending too much time waffling and not enough time driving. We're also going up a steep hill. Ah, now we're levelling off a little bit. It should be a bit better now. Mr. Trenko says, so it is a Black 5. So, Meshtool's also telling me the other variants otherwise include guard irons, white things on the front, whether they're present or not, window bars, and different light arrangements. So there are model variations between the different type as well. Sounds like a sort of a tram bell, doesn't it? There's our consist of wagons. Is the one with the pantograph, Darkness Monster says. No, I believe these are all just the battery loco variants. Right, so we're coupling up now. I love that electric hum when you put the power on. It's really awesome. So Mesh Tools have just told me, based on my comment, that it sounds like a tram bell. Apparently it's because it is a tram bell. Fair enough. Right, we have the wagons. Right, we've now got to get all the way down. So without putting any power on, I'm just going to let them drift for a minute. So we're coming down here. Now I need you to stay in this lane, road, whatever, and come down to here. Right, so the junctions are all set. We've got quite a large train of for a little thing like this. Back and let's go. He's looking at his watch. So this is Return to Maerdy that we're having a look here, and this includes some new freight rolling stock. It includes the battery loco in a number of different variations. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 variations by the looks of it. And it includes the J94 Austerity. The route itself is an updated version of the original Maerdy branch route, only it's been dated to 1970s. Right, we're getting going here. We're on the downhill now, so it's going to get remarkably easier to accelerate now. So I'm going to come off the power. One of the other things to bear in mind is that someone just asked about klaxon. There's the bell and the klaxon. I'm sure I was going to say something there, but I forgot what it was, so it can't have been that important. How many scenarios are included? I'll have a look in a minute. There's a few, actually. There's two for the battery loco, and I think half a dozen for the J94. So the J94 has had an awful lot of changes done to it. It's other than the fact that it looks very similar because it's a J94, it's barely recognisable. It's stunning to drive. So someone just asked about echo. I've got EFX switched on, and there's some echo in this part of the room. I don't know why, but that's why you're hearing echo. If you have EFX switched off, then you won't hear the echo. I like the sound of EFX. Right, so here we are on break 3, we're holding 10 on a 1 in 36, so you can see we're able to manage it. You don't want to go much above 10, otherwise it starts getting difficult to control. Meshtool say you can change the battery level in the scenario editor. That'll make for an interesting challenge. Still coming down this one in 93. Stevie Ladd, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. I'm also being told now that when stationary you can take the sandbox lids off. So we'll have a look at that once we get stopped. Just love this. Absolutely stunning quality. It really is. Speed's still holding just under 10, so we're okay. 1 in 32 now. The speed is creeping up. We're going to need to have a brief moment on brake 4, I think, just to keep the speed under control. Yeah, we're on that 1 in 29 devil's section. JW Blobman, do the lights use battery? They certainly do. On brake 4 just to keep the speed under control. Is there a meter that shows how much battery I've left? It certainly is. It's the volt meter up here, so it starts out at 400 and will gradually work down over the course of about 3 hours. Right, so we're on 1 in 50, so I'm going to start easing the rear brakes off a bit so that we can keep moving. 1 in 70. I think I'm going to have to stop shortly. Right, so we're going to come round here and up in between these two. Back off on brake 1 now. Now we're in the siding, I'm going to start get up with the rear brakes on a bit just to help the loco slow down. What we don't want is to have to spend too much, use the handbrake on when we're going too fast or it's just going to slide. Put a handbrake on, and we're slowing down now. This is where you find out he doesn't want to stop. But as we slow down, we can risk putting the brakes on a little bit more. Oh, listen to that. Listen to that. Right, we've stopped, so I'm going to pin them down and then unhook. Right, next up we're going to Maerdy Core Siding 1, which is just over here. So we need to come past the three-way switch and then change direction. So, while we're closed, I'm told to have a look at the sand things. I don't actually know where they are. Are they outside? Let me just find out where they are. Look behind the buffers. Oh look, sandboxes. Hang on, folks. Bear with me. Right, anyway, let's get moving. So, handbrake off. There you go, it was home and end. He's giving me the wrong information. So you've got the sand level in there, so we can press the home key and put that back on. Let's have a look and see what that one's doing, so you can see what your sander level is like. There you go. How awesome is that? Even more awesome when you're given the right instructions. Does the sand run out? Yes, the sand does indeed run out, and as you use the sand, I believe it goes down in there, so you can get a visual inspection of what they're like. But if you are moving... Oh, it does work. Okay. From what I thought, if you were moving, it wouldn't do that. Maybe I'm not going fast enough. Right, let's put some rear brake on. Isn't this a fabulous little loco? I can see me doing a lot of shunting with this loco. I really can. Bit premature on stopping there. We need to clear the switch point. Let's have a look at the cab view. So you've got this one. Press the right key. You've got out there. And then we've got a view in the middle, which gives you a good view of what's going on around here. One of the other things is as you apply and remove lights, if I control 1, control 3, you see the lights actually disappearing from here when they're going out onto the main, onto the loco. You've got these different views. Well, that's quite a nice one. I like that. I like that. Right. Put series 1 on and then release the brakes so we don't roll backwards. I probably should change the point first. There we go. How come the HUD shows brakes on the throttle and the brake control? So this is a like a combined handle type control. So it controls throttle and dynamic, effectively dynamic brakes, rear static brakes. stopped. Whereas the other side, this side here, what you would normally use as your train brake, is actually controlling this big lever here, which is your handbrake. So if I move the handbrake, you can see that that's moving. Right, take the power off that, reverse that, and release the handbrake. One thing that I've always really liked about this route is the vegetation, and this new update to it is no less impressive in that way. It looks you've got a really nice. You feel like you're running in a bit of an overgrown, sort of somewhat unloved area, because I think by this time the route was pretty much just all the passenger stations have closed by this time, and. All it was for travelling up and down for the coal. The HUD was gone when I did the brake thing. So yeah, if I move the brake, you can see the HUD is moving. Right, as soon as we're in here, I can stop. That's it. This isn't the scenario. I'm only going to get 800 points. Boo, I got 1,000 points earlier on. Glod in the past. So that's the first scenario done. Oh, I got a whole 300 points. Superb. Okay, so that's the first scenario. This is the 3B battery loco, which you'll use for your switching and your shunting. Right. One. Let me just put you back onto changing route for just a minute while I bring up the scenarios, because we can have a look at the scenarios. Yeah, we can look at the scenarios now. So this is all the scenarios that come in the pack. Some people were asking what they were. So there's two for the English Electric 3B, which is the battery loco we just looked at. We just ran training time. And then you've got these scenarios here. So you've got three scenarios using the advanced version of the J94, and three scenarios, the same three scenarios, but using the standard version of it. So the advanced version is not HUD compatible or Xbox controller. It's a keyboard and in-cab controls. You know, super realistic experience. Whereas the standard version is HUD, it's Xbox, and it doesn't have some of the finicky realistic factors that the other one has got. So it's a more approachable loco if you're not an expert at Steam. Now, I'm going to have a go at Uphill Struggle, we'll see how that goes, shall we? Because that's always good fun. Let's get that loading. So we're going to have a look now at basically this is the entire length of the route. And it is the...